If you are unable to obtain high quality leads off your websites, then your chance of success with Rank and Rent are very slim indeed. Now, even if you were able to rent your site to a client, chances are they're not going to stick around for very long. They're going to be very, very dissatisfied, and those rental agreements are going to quickly dry up. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you exactly what fantastic lead generation forms look like across several different niches. And I'm also going to be showing you exactly how you can find forms to replicate or base your forms on that have been battle tested and that you will know will lead to better results. Now, before I delve into this topic, I do just want to quickly mention that there is a link in the description below, and that will enable you to join my Rank and Rent community. We are having some really productive conversations in there. So if you want to take this business model seriously and you want to, you know, speed up your results and just get those rental agreements faster, then that really is the place for you. But with that said, let's delve into today's topic. So it all kind of falls down to this premise. So this is the core component of the message that I'm trying to relay to you in this video. What you need to do is a very, very fine balance, but you need to capture the right amount of relevant and useful information without overwhelming the customer. Now, I've put customer in quotation marks because they technically aren't our customer. They are our site visitors, and they essentially will be our clients' customer. And when I say a client, they are the businesses or the individuals who are renting our website. So they will ultimately be their customer. But we need to remember that this is all about serving our client. If we can serve our client, if we can provide them with high quality leads, then they will be so much more satisfied with our service, and they'll be so much more likely to either rent to begin with or to continue that rental agreement. Now, if we think about it, this applies to whether we are yet to get the rental agreement. So maybe we are in the process of sending them free leads to kind of get their interest and to get their buy-in to what we provide. Or it's also relevant to once we have the rental agreement in place and we are sending these to them more regularly. So if you just look at this here, what we need to do is we need to be very specific, but we need to essentially make the visitors' experience of our website and the whole process as fast as possible. So let's break down some of these in action. I'm actually going to start with a landing page, a lead capture form that is on one of my Rank and Rent assets. Now, this has been refined. I've tested this. I've used paid ads to get this kind of optimized, and this, from what I've seen in this particular niche, has been absolutely brilliant. So it's in the home renovation niche. And I'm just going to show you a little bit of how it looks. So I'm actually using Jetpack Forms for this. I do have other videos on the channel which explains why I use that particular plugin and functionality. It's entirely free. So there is other videos if you want to learn how to build this. But what I've done here is I've set this up as a series of questions. At the top, I've got almost, this is a H2 heading. And as you can see from the outset, it's there's various different kind of psychological components in here to get somebody to enter their information. So of course, the individual will be getting a free consultation. There's no obligation to commit to the service. When I say today, it's all about making them take action now. So that's that kind of heading. Into the actual elements of this form, you'll notice that three of the fields are required. So they can't submit the form without it. So we've got full name, and I've put these as questions because I feel it's more personal, and usually you get better quality input with these kind of elements of tweaking. So what is your full name? What email address can we reach you on? So it's very, very clear from the outset that we will be contacting them. What phone number can we reach you on? When is the best time to contact you? Now, this is a drop down. I've put mornings, afternoons, evenings, and weekends. We could make this, maybe we could slightly adapt this if we wanted to, but it just gives the visitor, you know, say they work a 9-to-5 job, you know, mornings, afternoons, it might not work for them. So you could have this as a multi drop down as well if you wanted to. But this is just, you know, an idea that is really working well for me. For this particular niche, I'm getting a lot of leads on the weekends, which makes sense because people are at work. Home renovation is the type of thing you look at the weekend. So, you know, these little tweaks can really, really help. The bottom field, which I believe is, you can't actually see, I believe the question is something like, what other information do you want to provide at this stage that will help us best serve you? Or just something like that, okay? And at the bottom, we've got submit. This could also be, you know, a tweak such as get your quote. You know, those are the kind of slight alterations that you could do. I feel like submit makes sense because this is a form. So as I say, this is one of my lead generation forms. It's doing really, really well. And hopefully you can see how this is kind of working. And you might even want to replicate this exact one on your site. But we've got other niches to look in. And these aren't, I'm going to be fully honest with you, these are not my websites. These are not my lead capture forms. I will show you shortly the process of how I found them and why I like them a lot. But let's just delve into them because chances are you'll be in one of these niches or you may even want to start a site in one of these niches. So the first, surprise, surprise, is roofing. So now one other quick caveat. This is, so I'm based in the UK, if you can tell by my accent. So this is, you may notice that this is a UK lead gen form and I'll explain why that's the case in due course. But if we just look at this from the outset, we've got name, email address, contact number. So very, very similar to what I've got. Service required. Now this is a drop down that has various different services. So this can be really, really good if you're going for a high level niche and you're offering sub niches as services. Perhaps you've got a client that only provides certain roof services as an example, and they don't do everything. Then you might want to just have what they provide as the drop down options, because that way the visitor lands on the site. They may have something very specific they need. As an example, chimney repair. It might not be listed here. They may think, okay, well, better find another. I might find another potential service provider who's going to do that for me. And you may think, well, I've lost a lead there. But you need to remember here, we don't want to be sending leads that are a waste of time to our potential clients, especially if we're yet to secure that rental agreement. Imagine if this is the first couple of free leads we send them and, you know, it's for a chimney repair and they don't offer that service. It's a waste of their time. They're not going to be too happy with that. We need to keep them on side. We want to make them happy. We are serving them at the end of the day. So property postcode, this pertains back to me being in the UK. So postcode is essentially the equivalent of a zip code in the States. Now, what this is essentially doing, excuse me, voice went very funny there. but this is basically helping them to refine where, if they can actually cover or they travel to that location, can provide the service. So this can be really, really important if you're a multi-location rank and rent site or you want to kind of focus on particular areas, and something like that you could include. So it's good information to capture, particularly if you know your client isn't willing to travel very far or, you know, those kind of things. Now, your inquiry, here's a good, nice little thing. So what they've done here is they've put like sample information in so the visitor can see this. Please provide us with more information about your inquiry. Something that's really, really good. Instead of something that just like message, which, you know, people don't know what to put in, make it really specific. Make it really, really specific. Now at the bottom here, we've got request your free roofing quote. Now I really, really like that. As you can see from mine, I've kind of got that at the top. I could put that again in the submit area, but that's another really good kind of button and CTA, so call to action. So that's roofing. So that's one you can kind of mirror. You could adapt this for the US with a zip code there as an example. On to plumbing. So plumbing, another very, very popular niche. I've kept these very, very high level, but I want to show you the subtle nuances between them and how that can actually really, really matter depending on what niche you go into. So this one, again, is another UK one. So it's almost a combination of both, actually. So we've got your name. So we've got first and last. You've got two fields there as opposed to one. Doesn't really matter, I suppose. Your postcode, that's a required field. Now, interestingly, this one isn't required. I don't quite know why they haven't got that information. You know, you can't really be very personal with your messages if they're not required. I mean, everyone's going to enter that information. But if they didn't, it can just be a little bit tricky, especially if you're sending these leads on to a client. Your phone number, that's required. Your email address is not required. So because we are renting or hope we are either renting our websites or looking to rent our websites, we need to provide as much information as possible. So make sure you make certain fields required. You need to send their names, really. You need to send their phone number and you need to send their email address. So this one, I don't actually think is a rank and rent asset, to be honest, but still, you want to make these required fields. Your preferred callback time. So that's something that I've obviously got on mine. And to be honest, it's because I went through the process of researching different lead generation forms and I found that this kept coming up. So that's really good to put in. People don't want to be bothered. They don't want calls. They don't want to be taking calls when they're busy. this little subtle nuance can be really, really important just to creating a better customer experience. And also when you think about it, if we're sending these leads to a potential client or a client, if they know that the potential customer at the end of the line is more receptive to picking up a call at that time or is more likely to, the whole process just gets much easier. If you're trying to get them, you know, your client on side, you're trying to secure a rental agreement, if you can be very, very specific and say, please, can you call them evenings on weekends, and they you know, they end up picking up the call, just think how much better the client is going to feel about your potential partnership, etc. So details about the issue you're having. So this is really, really important, because if we relate this back to plumbing is usually, people usually call a plumber when something goes wrong. So something like this can be really, really important for having on your form. So if you're in the plumbing niche or any area where there's a repair required or a breakdown or something that has gone wrong, make sure you perhaps include a field, is the correct word, and maybe have this kind of subtext, describe the issue you experience, just so people know exactly what to submit, okay? But you'll notice about all of these so far, they're not too overwhelming. We're not asking for too much information. We just want to be clear, and we need to collect the core information that's going to ultimately help our client. Now, lastly, and when I say lastly, don't stop watching, because as I say, I'm going to show you exactly how to find the right exact fields that you need on your forms. But the last one I'm going to be covering in terms of niches is tree surgeon. Now, again, this is kind of amalgamation of all those up above. We've got free quote at the top and get a quote at the bottom. You know, I'm not here to break these down and kind of, scrutinize or kind of pick them apart. But I'm just trying to show you how we can get the kind of optimal form for our site. So select inquiry, that's a drop down. So because this is a tree surgeon, that could be something like tree felling. That could be something like tree removal. I'm not entirely sure on the tree surgeon niche, but that will be essentially the different services they provide. Full name, phone number, your town, your postcode. Again, that relates back to the location. You can, if you're in the base in the US, then you can obviously update that for your specific needs. And then we've got details of inquiry. Now at the bottom here, we've got a recapture. Now that can be really, really useful, particularly if you just want to stop kind of bots and kind of really poor quality leads coming in. Now, unfortunately, part and parcel of this, and this is just a process and aspect that we need to bear in mind, we are gonna get a lot of rubbish leads or form submissions on our site. It's just one of those things, but a recapture can really, really reduce the number you get those in. So you'll get, like, I get hundreds a day, and they're literally like, we can provide the best SEO services to put you at the top of Google. It's like, I am at the top of Google. That's why you've been able to find my form, and that's why you've entered your information. It's crap like that. It really frustrates me. It's one of those processes. I'll probably produce a future video on how we can reduce these. Recapture is one of them. It is unfortunately just one of those things. But this is a good thing to have, okay? And that's when I've kind of brought this into this video. So now, how do you know exactly what fields to put on your form? So, well, hopefully I've given you some great advice and examples so far. So maybe you could just lift one of these. But there is a more strategic approach, particularly if you are in, you know, a really kind of bizarre niche. I shouldn't say bizarre niche, specific niche, or something that's very, very different. Or maybe you just have no idea. Well, of course, you can always go to ChatGPT and ask it. That is one approach, but it's not really what I do. What I'd actually recommend that you do is you head over to Google, and you can either do this in your exact service and location, or you could just use a kind of more higher level location. So as an example, if you're operating in, say, a particular city with a population of 100,000, you could just put in either, you know, you could put in the state or the county, obviously depends where you are based, UK, US, etc. Just to get kind of a, because usually these are more competitive, and usually you'll find that the better companies are kind of operating on a larger scale. Not always the case, but it's usually the case. And what you want to do, and I'm not a massive fan of doing this, and I'll explain why in a second, and be mindful, be respectful, these are businesses paying for ads, okay? But those companies that are paying for ads, they are going to have battle tested their lead gen forms. They are going to be refining them. They're paying a lot of money for these clicks. So they're going to want to optimize their landing pages, at least if they're respectable companies with a good budget. You know, some companies have so much money and budget that they just, some landing pages I see on sponsored posts, they're not optimized at all. It's shocking. But I'm not going to click on, I've already clicked on some of these, so I'm not going to click on them again. But this is the kind of search you'd do, and you'd look for these sponsored areas. You mean you could go on these kind of sites, you could go on the free listings, but as I say, these tend to be the companies that are really serious about getting leads. They're paying for ads. And what you can do is just open them up and you can just basically look at what they're doing. So as an example, this, it was for the tree surgeon in Essex. We've got almost like a process form here. So we've got kind of, we go through to the next page. We've got first name, surname, email address, phone. And then if you just look at this, yeah, as I say, it's a process. So you could maybe replicate something like this. I'm just going to put something in. Bob Willis. I don't want to submit this because it's not fair. It's not fair to send a false lead. I'm trying to be mindful and respectful here. So let's put next. I just want to get to the next page, basically. Okay. Full property address, country, message, image, submit. Does this need to be on two pages? Again, I'm not the person to say. I'm not critiquing this. But as you can see, what I'm just trying to show you is the kind of fields that they are providing and which you may want to replicate. So that is an example of tree surgeon. Again, you could run a similar search. So this was, say, roofing in, I think it was London. Interestingly, East Anglia, their East Anglia landing pages come up. That must be just the way they set up their ad. Here's another one. Request a free survey and quote. One of our experienced roofing specialists will call to arrange a survey and answers to any questions you have. So here's a good idea. Perhaps put in a sentence or two about what will happen if someone was to enter their information into your lead gen form. Name, email, telephone. Please give us any details about the roof, postcode, request survey. What I quite like about this one is how they've, it's not kind of all listed down. It's kind of listed across. So it just takes up less page estate. And because this, I think it's quite far down the page, but still, it's just ideas. It's just something you could implement. Obviously, it depends on your functionality of your site, your plugins, what's available to you. But it just gives you ideas, okay? The last one, and it says here, this form is protected by recapture. So again, they're trying to minimize spam. The next one is a tree surgeon. This is actually the one that I showed you in earlier on this particular page. It's this one here. So I won't walk you through that. But what I like about this particular lead capture form is it's right at the top of the page. For some reason, the others, it's really far down. I don't really know what they're doing. Obviously, they're probably trying to get the confidence of the visitor, which is very, very important. People don't usually just enter their information without reading anything and learning about who you are. But I like to put multiple forms on the page, one right at the top, one right at the bottom, maybe one in the middle. Just give them plenty of opportunities to do it. You know, sometimes people are desperate and sometimes people do just submit right from the outset. You don't want to bury it in the page. And that's what this company has done, which, as I say, I'm not here to critique, but, you know, that's what they've done. But as I say, the tree surgeon's right at the top. I like that. And as you see, this is an example of two. There's two here. They've got slightly different lead gen forms. I probably would have the same. Again, don't want to critique. Now here is the other one. This is the plumbers. Again, I found this via a paid ad. But you see all the different fields here. So that's how you do it. You go into Google, service location, see, you could check the free organic listings, see, especially those more at the top, see what they're doing, and you can kind of replicate, change, adapt from there, maybe improve it from there. Maybe they're missing one of these fields. Alternatively, check out the ads. Any questions, feedback, comments, drop them down below, I'll get back to you. If you want to join that community, link in the description. And with all of that said, best of luck with your rank and rent project.